guidelines recommending all children getting their cholesterol levels checked. A government-appointed panel suggests screening kids between 9 and 11 and then begin again between 17 and 21. But some critics say this new guideline is just too aggressive and we're simply influenced by financial ties to cholesterol drug makers. Dr. Renee Jenkins from the Howard University College of Medicine joins us. Dr. Jenkins, thanks so much for being here.
Thank you, Sean, for having me.
We can't deny the childhood obesity epidemic. So what's wrong with checking cholesterol at the age of 9?
We've been checking cholesterol in children for a while now, especially high-risk young people who have family histories that are consistent with high cholesterol levels, as well as children who are overweight. So we've been doing it for a while. I think the new recommendation has been argued over time. If you look at some of the Google articles around the Journal of Adolescent Medicine or the Journal of the American Medical Association, this has been a debate for a while.
So let me ask you, you brought up a good point. You guys have already been testing children who seem to be in that at-risk category.
Exactly.
That certainly makes sense, but does it make sense to test every child?
The problem is that we don't always have good family histories about a parent with a high cholesterol. And so, you know, when there's no information, we need to do the screening. And I think we've been able to see that sometimes we're not able to identify the risk and the young person still has an elevated cholesterol. So I think we're really focused on prevention and, you know, taking a blood test once for a screening, I think really balances the risk with the benefit potentially of intervening for this child.
How do you respond to critics who say these tests are not necessarily about the health of a child, but about the profit of the drug makers, the cholesterol drug makers?
Right. The percentage of children who actually end up on statins is very low. I think I've read like 1%. So we're not talking about large margins. What we're really doing now is trying to understand more about the effectiveness of these drugs in very, very high-risk children and the safety profile.
So bottom line, what advice do you have for parents out there?
I think parents should talk to their pediatricians about the screening. They should be aware of the screening as an option, and they should work it out with the pediatrician.
All right, sounds good. Dr. Renee Jenkins from the Howard University College of Medicine, thanks so much for coming in.
Thank you.